Thank you, Ken Corbett. Taoiseach, statistics published in recent days show how low a Garda presence there is in many rural Garda stations. And no doubt you and the Minister for Justice will use this as to justify the closure of Garda stations across rural Ireland as part of the review of the Garda Síochána Cana's capacity to operate with reduced resources. Almost a third of all Garda stations are staffed by just one Garda. 88 have just two serving guards, and while 40 stations are without any permanent Garda assigned to duty at all. This should not be used as a reason to close stations, but to reconsider the ban on new recruits that has been imposed. Counties like Donegal, Galway, Mayo and many others will face massive closures because of this ban. As things stand, it can take a squad car from the nearest station up to 2 hours if you're lucky to get to its destination when it's called out. In one incident recently in Donegal, the squad patrol car had to travel 45 miles to attend a serious arson incident. And I know of many numerous areas in Donegal that have been plagued by burglaries and vandalism where criminals have no fear because they know they won't be caught. It's even gotten to the stage where people are so afraid that some people living on their own, when they're going to bed at night, are leaving €50 out in the kitchen table in case their house is burgled, so that the burglar will take it and leave. And that's no way to live. And the fact that this is going on before the proposed any more cuts makes it all the more worrying. We have already seen the closure of nearly 40 stations this year, and it's been reported that it could be up to 80 more will face closure. This isn't efficient, Taoiseach. It's just dangerous. Can you therefore inform the House of your plan for tackling crime in rural areas and how exactly you equate less stations and less Gardaí with more efficiency? How many more closures will we see in year's end, Taoiseach? And for how many more years will we see closures happening before you lift the recruitment embargo and ensure the safety of all citizens?
Thank you. Taoiseach?
I think Deputy Pringle is aware that the nature of contact between the Gardaí and the public has changed over the years, and the requirement for that has been very clear. The fact of the matter is that there are now 664 stations around the country. Scotland has, with a population of 5.2, has 340 stations. Northern Ireland has 85 stations to return to, I think it's 45. The decisions made here are of interest both in town and country. Now, I've seen it myself over many years. There's actually a little point in having a Garda sit in a decrepit building for 2 hours on a Wednesday, to sign unemployment assistance forms when what the public demand is visibility, connection, availability and contact. And I'm glad to say that with the work of the Minister for Justice and all concerned, rosters have been changed, monies have been made available for through the capital vote for the purchase of new vehicles for Gardaí. The communications capacity of the Gardaí has changed. And what the public demand, both in rural Donegal and everywhere else, is that they know where the Gardaí can be contacted if and when they're needed, and that the public have visibility of them moving through their communities, and there are a variety of opportunities that present themselves in that regard. The question of the closure of Garda stations obviously will follow on any recommendation made by the Commissioner of the Gardaí to the Minister for Justice, and the vote for next year in respect of the Garda Síochána is one for the budget, but as you're aware, we have absolute support for the work that the Gardaí do in this country, day and night, and I want to compliment them on having accepted the changes to rosters which allow for greater availability and visibility of the Gardaí at times when they are more required, where people gather or where crowds are or whatever. So it's the same old story. If you think that it's that the best method of having Garda contact with the public is to be sitting for 2 hours on a Wednesday in a 100-year-old building, where if anybody had an intention of criminal activity anyway, it's not there they'd be going. What the Gardaí need, Deputy Pringle, is community contact, town and country, availability, visibility, contact and connection. And that's the changing face. That's the changing face of interaction with the public, insofar as the Gardaí are concerned. And that's why the Minister for Justice has, with the cooperation of the Gardaí, changed many of the structures for the better.
Deputy Pringle, I think there's only one Deputy Pringle in the House, so perhaps you'd listen to him. Thank you.
The change in face, as you describe it, the Garda Review has recently described these changes as a victory for criminals. And the fact is that the closure of rural Garda stations means that Gardaí are not in contact with the community. And so guards have to travel over 50 miles to emergency call-outs. That is hardly a progress in terms of policing. Since 2008, the number of guards has reduced by over 1,000. And staffing levels in 108 Garda districts have fallen by over 10%. The Gardaí can't access staff, they can't access vehicles in many rural areas, and they can't access the public because they've no means of getting there. And is that the kind of Garda and policing you want to see across the country, Taoiseach?
No, what I want to see is that the public have confidence in the Gardaí, in the officers who conduct business on behalf of the public, that they have the resources to do the job that they require. That's why over 200 new Garda cars have now been purchased by decision of government because of the clapped out nature of a number of them with very high mileage. There will be additional vehicles purchased for the Gardaí in 2013. Obviously, the operation which has targeted burglars has resulted in over 2,500 arrests and 1,400 charges. Which is significant in the context of the guards, finding out who these people are and having had 1,400 charges brought against them. But I think, Deputy Pringle, the important point here is that the Gardaí have changed the way they do their business in terms of the rosters. Their visibility, both on the streets and throughout the country, has changed in the last number of years because of the changes to those rosters. Their capacity to be connected, to be contacted, and to contact themselves even down in Tipperary, the communications system works so much better than it did previously. And that's important for people who want to know what the Garda confidential line is, who can have contact with their Garda when they need them. And if you think, Deputy McGrath, that sitting in an ivy-covered building that needs 100,000 to do it up for 2 hours on a Wednesday is the way to do justice in this country, then you're out of touch. I want to see, and the Minister wants to see, and the Commissioner, the Gardaí active in communities, interacting with people, being available to them, being seen by them, which engenders confidence and information, which is very important in the way that the Gardaí do their business. Things have changed, Deputy Pringle, and the capacity of the Gardaí to reach into communities, town and country, is changing with it. We need to use the modern methods of transport, of communications, of connection in the interest of that.
Thank
and
you.
If you want a new patrol car, you yourself came into contact with the Gardaí some time ago, and you should be very careful about that.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.